In the last episode, I explained how to create a basic point counter. Now we're going to improve this by adding a cool animation to every change that happens to the counter, like I did in one of my Game Jam games. Theoretically, we could animate the UI with Unity's default animations, but better for your performance is so-called tweening. I highly recommend using the free LeanTween library, which is super easy to use and useful in a lot of situations. If you don't want to use it, there are also other tweening libraries, and of course, you can still use the default Unity animations. But this tutorial uses this library. To download LeanTween, go to the Unity Asset Store and search for LeanTween, or click the link in the description. Like I said, it's free, and you can add it to your assets and import it. When this import dialog shows up, make sure to deselect the examples. The package comes with all those materials and scenes and scripts. But if you want to see those cool features, you can always install them in a new project and check them out there. Now we will create a prefab for how this change number should look like. I add a fitting example text and color. To save it as prefab, just create a prefabs folder and drag and drop this object in this folder. To define a start point, where we want to instantiate our prefabs later on, I add an empty game object. Place it to the position you like. Now in our point HUD script we created in the last episode, I add references for our newly created objects. The prefab as game object and our wrapper element of type transform. Let's create a new method called showPointChange, which will get an integer as parameter, which will represent the number of our change. And call this method whenever the point setter is called. We can now instantiate a new object from our prefab, where I use the position from the parent element as spawn position. With the setParent method, I set the parent for our object in the hierarchy. The second argument defines if you want to keep the current position. The position of an object is measured based on its parent. So without a parent, a position of 000 is exactly in the center of your scene, but with a parent, it will be set to the center of the parent. Now that we set the parent's position already as our object's position, we want to keep the position and let Unity transform it so that the object will stay in place. Its transform position will change, but we will still see it in the same place. Another option would be to spawn the object at a vector 3, 0 and set the boolean for world position stays to false. This means the position vector 3 will stay exactly the same at 0, but will change the position we see for our element. Now that we can see that the spawning works as expected, let's define the end position to where we want to move. I create an empty object on the same x-axis, but change the y-value. And we need to add a reference to this endpoint of type rectransform. For LeanTween to move UI elements, we need the rectransform component of this element. Now we can use LeanTween's moveY method for the tweening. The first parameter is our rectransform. The second is a float as our endpoint. Here we use the y value from the property anchored position of our rectransform endpoint. The last parameter is the duration time. I choose 1.5 seconds. Now let's test this. Make sure to assign the endpoint object to the new variable. The numbers move and stay at their end position. Great, so let's destroy them. We want to destroy the object after 1.5 seconds, after the tweening ended. But instead of waiting for this duration, we can use a nice callback handler LeanTween brings with it. Just add setOnComplete to your movement, and inside an anonymous function, we can now destroy the instantiated object. I also want to decrease the alpha value, the opacity of the text, during its movement. So I use the alpha text method from LeanTween. The first argument is again our rectransform component from the instantiated object. The second is the target alpha value between 0 and 1. And I set the exact same duration as in our other tweening, 1.5 seconds. You can see it works. But I think the alpha could be even lower, something like 0.25. So, if you watched carefully, you may have noticed that the +5 text we can see is nowhere changed. We just take the value, which is the standard of the prefab. So, let's tackle this last problem, and I will show you also how to change the color based on your number. I changed the color and text of the prefab to something different to show you that it works. When changing values inside a prefab in your hierarchy, make sure to overwrite the prefab file here. And make sure it's not set to inactive when overwriting the prefab, or else it will spawn like this. To change the text, we need the text component first. Then we can change the text exactly like we do this to our main point counter, but we will use the change parameter we got from the method call. To preserve this plus sign in front, I'll add a simple decision if this value is greater 0 or not. This is called a ternary operator. The statement in front of the question mark is the same as you would write in an if statement. If this statement is true, whatever is written before the colon will be executed. If it's false, the code behind the colon is executed. In this case, I want to add a string with the plus sign if the value is greater 0. If it's below 0, I don't want to add anything. But since this ternary operator is adding a string in the case of true, I need to match this, so I'll add an empty string. Make sure to add the parentheses, like this, to always show the text, independent of your ternary statement. To change the color, we can do the same thing. Let's add two serialized color fields, one for green and one for red. You can change the text color with this statement. Instead of simply setting a color, we will set the color based on the result of the ternary operator, like we did with the text. Now in your Unity inspector, you can adjust the color values. Make sure to increase the alpha value as well, which is unfortunately always set to 0. It works. Well, almost. We only want to show the changes that are added to the point value. This happens because we call the showPointChange method with the value that will override the latest point value. So let's just subtract the points from the value so that we will get the difference before the variable gets overwritten. And now, all our values are green +5. Be aware that this approach is fairly simple and can lead to stacked values when points are added or subtracted in a small time span. And I think it would be much cooler if the total point value would change first when the change object disappears. You know, like it moves and then it's added to the value. This can be easily done by changing the point counter value not at the same time, but rather after the tweening ended. If you watched carefully, I'm sure you know how to do this. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed the content, consider liking and subscribing, and I'll see you next time.